These are the solar driveway lights. I got a little solar panel on top. And on the blog I go to, survivalistblog.net, a guy named River Rider said that you could buy these at Walmart, and they've got AA batteries in them that are rechargeable. And I bought one. And sure enough, it's got a standard rechargeable AA battery in it. So I've got some old rechargeable batteries that I used to use in a digital camera. I'm going to put them in here, and I'm going to set these out in the sun and see if it works, if I can take the batteries out and use them in my flashlight. Won't that be cool? A free way to charge AA batteries.
Okay, I just can't stick these things in the ground like they were intended to. No, I got to make it a little more complicated. That's just the way, that's just how I roll. These stakes are intended to be driven in the ground, and then this to be set on them like that. But I'm going to screw these down to this 1x4, and it's hard to do that looking through the viewfinder. I missed it. There. So those will be screwed to this board like that. And then I'm going to mount this board in a way so it can be swiveled to follow the path of the sun, you know? Like in the morning, have this oriented north to south and tilt it a little bit to the east. And then about noon, come out, set it straight up. And then in the afternoon, turn it towards the west to get full charge out of these little solar panels. So I'm going to set this up, and I'll show you what it looks like. Okay, I've got the little spikes mounted on this board here. And it looks like it's finished. But wait, is there any way I could make this more complicated? I think I can. Well, I managed to make it a little more complicated. I mounted it to a pipe with a wing nut that you can loosen. And aim this towards the sun. And not only that, but you can turn it as the year progresses. And as the sun settles in the west, you could point it towards the west just to get that much more direct sunlight on those little solar panels. And now the real test is going to be to put them rechargeable AA's in here and see just how well it does. And that'll be my next clip. Well, here's the thing I made. I pulled it back out of the ground because you couldn't turn it like this, and the reason is I had cut this point on the end and then hammered it down into the ground, and it wouldn't turn easy enough. So not wanting to make this as easy as possible, I'm making a little rod here. For this is going to be hammered in the ground right here, and then this is going to slide over it like that, and it'll rest on that big washer, and it'll be able to turn without any problem. And I got these washers just tacked on here right now. I'm fixing to weld them washers on good and grind the diameter. I'll have to grind the diameter a little bit in order to fit up in here, but I'll show you the finished product. Okay. In my junk drawer in the kitchen, I had these rechargeable batteries that I used to use in my digital camera. And they've been in there, God, probably a year and a half, maybe two, just sitting there. So I'm pretty sure they're completely dead, or nearly dead. And I'm fixing to put them in the solar lights. And my next clip will be of me hammering this stake in and showing you my latest complication to this thing. Breezy, you're hogging my shot. All right, there it is. I'm fixing to slide the bracket I made over that. Now, you see the way the shadow is? I'm going to aim this perpendicular with that line of that shadow. And I won't aim this up. You probably won't be able to see the sun. But the sun is just a little past noon. It's probably 1:30, something like that. I got a little wrapped up there in my shop complicating this. So I'm going to lean this towards the sun. There we go. And in about 4 hours, when the sun goes down, I'll come out here and pull them batteries out and stick them in a flashlight and see if they've charged them up. Well, the sun's getting a little lower. It's 5 p.m. And I'm going to pull a couple of these batteries out and stick them in a flashlight and see if 3.5 hours of sunshine has charged them up enough to light a flashlight. So I only got one available hand, and it's going to take two hands to undo the lids off of these and pull the batteries out. So the next clip will be of me turning the flashlight on to see if it's got enough juice, the batteries. Okay, I got the lids off. I got the batteries out. And look at this. It's not 100% bright, but for just a couple hours of charging, that's pretty impressive. So, in the event you don't have electricity and you need a way of charging up some AA batteries using solar, these were $4 each. And, you know, a couple hours of fabricating this little thing, but you don't really have to have that. You could jam these in the ground and they'd do just fine. So that's a pretty handy thing to know, and I owe River Rider a debt of gratitude.